Do you know what's going on with West Ham at the moment? It's absolutely crazy. Completely mental. We just smashed our transfer record. Players coming in, left, right and centre. World-class manager. It's not West Ham, I recognise. Very, very strange times. I'm going to get into all of that. We're going to talk about the game at Wickham. Lots of players coming in. We got some formation stuff. We got some of your views. But before we get into all that, I'm going to shamelessly plug an app. Now, for those of you that watch the vlogs, it's the app that I use in the vlogs when I'm starting up and I get the starting lineup. It's the app that pings the West Ham starting lineup to my phone. But it's a lot more than that. The reason I like this app, it's called the One Football app, is because you can tailor it to just give you the stuff that you need to know. You don't have to find out all that Tottenham stuff and all that rubbish. You actually just go in, you set your favourites. So I set mine up as West Ham, obviously, for the World Cup. I change it to England, and then what it just does is once you've clicked on that, you just get all the news just pertinent to the stuff that you've clicked. I do sometimes use it if we've got an away game and we're playing an opposition team, so it'll give me their team news and whatnot. But by and large, all it'll do, you just click on One Football and it just gives me all the West Ham news sort of all in one. Be it transfer news, team reports, injury news, that sort of thing. Pretty quick to update as well. It's in the link below. Best of all, it's free. If it was rubbish, I wouldn't recommend it to you, quite frankly. So it's in the link below. Give that a click. Download it to your phone. Click off all the other teams and then just use the bits that are relevant to you. That's it. Right. Philip Anderson. What can I say? I mean, he's just what the manager wanted. He was the manager's number one pick. I don't think Lazio were easy to deal with at all. I think they've had a terrible time dealing with him. In fact, when Sullivan stepped back, that is when the new director of football has been able to close the deal. We don't know a lot about the guy, but from what I can tell, he loves to take on a player. He loves to dribble, can go left, can go right. Most of the clips that I've dug up and had a look of have been him just going at people constantly. He's not afraid to run with a ball. He's going to get us up the pitch quickly. I mean, he's fast. Ball over the top, not bothered at all. He'll go past and he'll finish. He'll finish quite smartly. He seems to have quite audacious skills as well. So he's going to twist, turn, jink, nutmeg, pirouette, all that sort of stuff. Listen, if the manager wanted him, and he's the manager's number one choice, then who are we to argue? It gets to the point where you've just got to trust in the vision and in what the manager's doing. And hopefully, like Yarmolenko, he is going to link up really, really well with Marko Arnautović. Now, Arnautović, as I said yesterday, for those of you that saw the video, had an ice pack on. Apparently, it was just a dead leg. So I did actually see Arnautović a little while after that. And he said, whilst he was limping when he went over to see the fans, apparently it was just a dead leg, but I did actually just see him. He was walking. He was walking and walking quite easily. And you're just seeing the footage there, which I took myself. He's walking without any limp or anything like that. So, fingers crossed, he's all right. It's certainly nothing serious at all. As I say, that was from the Wigan game yesterday. In terms of other injuries, Mikel Antonio was there, getting back to fitness, was very, very keen. I spoke to him and he'd actually driven all the way up there, not got the coach up with all the other players. He didn't even have to turn up. So he'd driven up and there was horrendous traffic, as I mentioned on the video. But he drove up anyway just to see the team. And I could see him interacting with everyone, saw him interacting with Pellegrini, went and sat on the bench. He was just in his civvy clothes and all the rest of it. Said he was looking forward to the season. What was his name? Byram didn't start, didn't feature at all. Minor injury. Fredericks was there. I mean, not only did he watch the game, he pretty much stood up and watched the whole game as well. And he was signing autographs of fans, having selfies. You've probably seen a few of them online. He just rolled his ankle. I don't know what rolled your ankle actually means, but I'm guessing it is not too bad. He seemed fine, ready to go. I think he'll feature in the next game. Obviously, the Andy Carroll stuff, well, the less said about that, the better. And Winston Reid, we covered that in the cup of tea. The other one was obviously Jack Wilshere. I've covered that in the video as well. He starts full training on Monday, which hopefully, if I get this video edited on time, will be tomorrow. Some of the other players that played, I mentioned Yarmolenko linking really, really well with Arnautovic, and it was just a really, really good exercise in there to see so many of the team, playing in what was a really nice environment. So many of the West Ham fans turned up as well, and just the players really reacted really well. So I do think it was more of a fitness thing rather than reading too much into anything. But what you could read into was the way Noble was just linking with everybody. I think Cullen didn't play too badly at all. In fact, he may well have done enough to make the manager not want to sell him on. He might just be a bit part player in the squad, but he certainly could pass it and move in a way that I think is probably going to appeal to Pellegrini. Obiang was there as well, so it's Obiang, Noble and Cullen in the middle. Yarmolenko, as you see, he's predominantly left-footed, but he wasn't afraid to sort of jink over and use his right foot just to put a crossover when needed. If you look here, Mark Noble, again, he put a lovely ball through for Arnautovic, who just typically used his strength to hold the defender off. Apparently he was a Wigan captain, and put the ball low into the corner. So, you know, there was lots to be happy about. This is actually a Wigan attack here. And if you look, there's a couple of ball boys up in the corner who I was actually stood next to at the time, who were absolutely gutted that Wickham didn't score. But they came more into the game in the second half, Wickham. And do you know what? Just a really, really, really nice team. Really nice club, family club. And I wish them really, really well. But the fans were great. The West Ham fans were great. They were really loud. Actually, there was a lovely bit in the half-time where the groundsman had put the sprinklers on. And West Ham fans were saying, come on, soak us. And they sprayed the West Ham fans. Give the West Ham fans a lovely soaking, which was a nice touch. In terms of how West Ham are going to play, Connor done a little graphic for me. Thank you very much for doing it, Connor. And he's done one for Gio as well, which you can see on the on hammerschat.com, of what we think the teams are going to be for next season. Now, this was done before I'd seen the Wigan game, and I've actually changed my mind ever so slightly. The back is all the same. Fredericks, Diop, Ogbonna, Crosswell. I'm pretty confident he's going to play Ogbonna and Diop together. It looked like he wanted them to form a partnership. I just think probably Arnautovic will go into Hernandez's position. Wilshere will go where I put Arnautovic in that. And I think we'll probably see Noble and Rice together. Although, I tell you now, it was quite telling watching everybody warm up, because they did seem to be in different groups. And I just wonder about Rice. There was almost three groups, and I might be reading more into it than I need to, but anyone that got to the game early and sat in a stand and you know what I mean, and was cooling down, having a drink and whatnot, and saw the warm up, they'll know what I'm saying. There was very much almost a first team, and I don't mean ones that are just starting, but what you would consider senior players. And then there was a separate group warming up. Rice was part of that. And then you had the younger group again, which was Samuelsson, Reece Oxford, and Nathan Holland, who played very, very, very well. But then again, Nathan got the whole of the second half, but Declan Rice didn't. So if I'm reading into it, that Diop and Ogbonna are both going to start as the centre-back partnerships, then it's hard to know what's going to happen with Rice, because he just didn't seem to be part of it. Certainly Noble, though, seemed to be talking with Pellegrini quite a lot. No, you can't tell from the folks, they hate each other, but that certainly wasn't the case there. It did seem that Pellegrini was certainly involving him an awful lot in what was going on. So, you know, it's hard to read into it. We're going to have to wait. I don't think we'll know until the first competitive game of the season. Maybe the one just before. Maybe we might start getting a glimpse. We'll be very interested to see who he picks at right back, who he's going to pick at left back, his centre back pairing, what's going to happen in midfield. But do not rule out a loan or a free signing coming in and something happening to shake that up a little bit, really.
Henderson, he's a Brazilian. He's Philip Henderson. Oh, we got that one, Dave. Let me have a go. He's Philip Henderson. He's a Brazilian.
Anderson.
Thank you for the funds, Mr. Chairman. I have one or two more questions for you.
How much more do you need to spend?
More mischief from Canning Town Len, of course. You can find him at Canning Town Len on Twitter. He's always up to no good. He's a very, very naughty boy, Len. Just to keep you informed, if you are watching this and you're not subscribed to the channel, please just check on your phone, because it's ever so easy to miss it. And what subscribe means is that every time we do a video, you get notified about it. We don't bombard you with a load of old nonsense, but you can keep up to... We've got Michael Mundy coming tomorrow, all the other videos we do, Canning Town Len, all the stuff I do, which is best ignored. But all you got to do is press subscribe on your phone where it says subscribe. Just push on it, or your laptop, and then you'll see a little bell will pop up. Press the bell as well, because then the bell means that you get the notification. Do that on your phone now, and then you subscribe to all that stuff, and you won't miss a thing. Now, on to Manuel Pellegrini. I don't think you can understate quite how much he has probably had to coerce the owners into spending this money. You've got to think that there's no way they would get a manager of his standing without pledging to spend the money that he needed. And to see us spend 100 million, quite frankly, is weird. It is just a little bit weird. I'm sure there'll be a couple of sales, but even if there were, they're not going to recoup 100 million. And you know what? I think people would understand a couple of sales, unless they sell a biggie like, you know, Declan Rice or like Arnautovic, then it's almost, you know, all the goodwill is going to be undone. But I'm pretty sure that when Pellegrini came in, he's not going to agree to sell in the best players. He just wants that money on top. And it just goes to show, when you get a good team involved, then good stuff starts to happen. Since the director of football, who's a trusted lieutenant, Pellegrini, has come in, since he's come in, the signings have just been one after another. And again, going back to that Wigan game, watching his team together, and by his, I mean his assistant coach and the first team coach and the fitness coach, they are a very, very tight-knit unit. I don't know how much language has got to play with it, but there was a bit in the... when was it? In the first half, when I was watching the fitness coach, I was 2 yards from the fella, and he was taking a load of players through the warm-up, and his English was okay. I mean, I've got to say, it was manageable. They understood what he was saying. I understood what he was saying. Whether he would have understood what I was saying is another matter. But I was quite impressed. But I was just, it was just an interesting dynamic to watch him. I'm talking about Pellegrini here, with his sort of trusted lieutenants. And it was good. It could all unravel, really, couldn't it? Let's be fair. So let me just preempt what I'm about to say with a dose of realism. But it does seem very exciting, and I think it's only our historical ineptitude which is really making me just try and be a little bit calm and not get too carried away, which is my nature anyway. But I'm really looking forward to the season. I'm really looking forward to these players. I said in the video, for those of you that didn't see it yesterday, and thank you for the comments that were on there, by the way. I did read every single one of them. Well, apart from the geezer that said we were going to go down and we bought a load of rubbish. You can do one. Apart from that, thank you very much for all the comments on there. But I said in that video that we've become a very, very big team. Now, I don't know about these rumours about Yaya Toure, but if we were to bring in someone of that stature as well, then we'd be absolute mayhem. We'd cause absolute mayhem from set pieces. Jan Malenko's big, and Arnautovic is big. Diop is a big boy. We know Ogbonna's a threat. And the thing is, we were easy enough to defend, because I think when you've got one or two tall players, you just put your best headers on them. When you've got five or six tall players, then the opposition have a problem, because unless they are sort of Tony Pulis's old Stoke, then you're not going to have that. Man United, Jose Mourinho, he likes a big team, doesn't he? But in the main, I do think we're going to be able to cause teams some problems, not just with our skill, not just with our pace, because I do think that's going to be a fundamental part, but also just from our height and our strength. It's going to be very, very interesting. People are going to have to really think about defending against us in open play and from set play. So very, very much to look forward to. And I also think, well, do we dare to dream? I mean, if you've got a manager like Manuel Pellegrini, and players like Anderson and Arnautovic, then all of a sudden it propels us from being a mid-table Premier League club to a club that's sort of recognised on the international stage, that the Premier League is watched all over the world. And maybe we become a recognised name up there with some of the biggest teams.
Have you, you like football, yeah?
Yeah.
The Premiership?
Yes.
The Premiership?
Yeah.
What Premiership teams do you know?
Man United.
Yeah, Man United, of course.
Chelsea.
Chelsea, yeah, big club.
Yeah.
West Ham.
West Ham, yeah.
Yeah. Liverpool.
Yeah.
Man City.
Well, yeah, good, you named loads. What about Tottenham? You heard about Tottenham, didn't you?
What?
The Tottenham. Tottenham Hotspur.
Topspur?
No.
What's that?
You never heard of them?
No.
I know. They lost the World Cup, apparently. Anyway, moving swiftly on, Mr. B, aka Ian, has very excitedly sent me a video, so I'm going to play that now. I'll be back afterwards. Let's see what Mr. B has got to say about all this ridiculous transfer activity.
So, after weeks and weeks and weeks of protracted negotiations, it's finally been announced that Felipe Anderson is a hammer. Deal's done, they got it over the line, and he is all ours. And I am a very, very happy hammer with that signing, as I am with the other six. I think, for me though, the signing of the summer is Pellegrini, because I don't think you can underestimate the draw of that man and how he's been kind of instrumental in just the fact he is Manuel Pellegrini to bring some of these players in. You know, if we'd have still had Moyes or, I don't know, Fat Sam or even Slav, would we have got the likes of Yarmolenko and particularly Felipe Anderson? No, we wouldn't. But we've got them. They're ours. And I am absolutely buzzing for this coming season. The whole squad has been notched up, you know, one if not two levels above what we had last season, I think the good times are finally here. I just say I've supported West Ham for a long, long time, and I can't ever remember going into a season with this much buzz, not just for the players we've bought, but for the fact we're actually going to be watching an attacking style of football. You know, we've had years of defend for your life, and you know, if you can snatch a draw or something or a victory, then happy days. But you know, we are now going to be going out there looking to beat people up, looking to, you know, play expansive attacking football, score goals for fun, you know, and hopefully play football like, you know, when we see the teams like Manchester City and people like that, who, you know, I look at them thinking, my God, I'd love West Ham to play like that. I think this season we are going to play like that. Absolutely buzzing. The signings, I think, all good. Fabianski, solid keeper, and I think he's going to be there or thereabouts, whether or not they go for him or for Adrian as a number one. I wouldn't like to call it personally, but he's an upgrade on Hart, so what a good backup keeper. Fredericks, I think, when he beds in, he's going to be a really, really decent right back. Diop looks good. I've only seen bits and pieces of him, but he's a big lad. He's going to be great with set pieces as well, both attacking and defending, because he's a bit of a unit. But as I say, good age as well. Him and Fredericks, both young guys. You know, we're not going out buying pensioners anymore. You know, this is what we want, young people. You know, the general, Balbuena, don't know anything about him, but, you know, again, you see bits and pieces of footage. Whether he can adapt, I don't know, but he looks a good defender when you see clips. I mean, okay, you could probably say that about some of the donkeys that we've signed in the past, but this time round, I judge sort of Pellegrini's judgment, and I think he'll come in and I think he'll do a job. You know, Wilshire, what a brilliant signing, choice of all those clubs. He's come to West Ham. You know, he's going to be adored anyway because he was a hammer as a lad, but he's you know, he's just what we want. Somebody who can give a little bit of craft and guile in midfield, not afraid to put his foot in, shows a bit of passion. He's going to be a superhero. And then, you know, look at the two wingers we got. Yarmolenko, what a signing. I mean, he was a real superstar in Ukraine. I think we were in for him with Everton a couple of seasons ago, but he went to Dortmund, didn't he? You know, Champions League football and all that. You know, you couldn't blame him for not giving Germany a go, but I think he's going to be a fantastic signing for West Ham. Absolutely fantastic. He's got a wonderful left foot, and just brilliant. And in icing on the cake, Felipe Anderson, smashing our transfer record, not just by a little bit, absolutely smashing it. This is a squad where we could really start doing things, and it's a real statement of intent of how we're going to attack the Premier League next season. I can't wait. Absolutely buzzing. Not just to see the players, but to see us play decent attacking football. Roll on, August. Come on, you Irons.
Ian, a.k.a. Mr. B there, our Cornish correspondent reporting from a bush. I don't know. Ask him yourself. He's on Twitter. I'd forgotten all about Fabianski. I think I've mentioned a few of the others. Forgotten all about Fabianski. Ian said backup keeper. Will he? I've got him. I've got Adrian in my team, as you saw earlier. So I obviously think Fabianski is going to be a backup keeper. I know there are many who think he's going to be first choice. Let me know your teams, please, as well. And then when I've read them all, I can go through it when we do our next YouTube, and myself and Mike will go through them all. And we'll discuss it. All we can do is guess. That's about all we can do until we know more about the manager, which we actually know very, very little, until he stops sort of swapping the teams around from one after the other. We're not going to have too many clues, but we just hope we can see as much of the next games as possible. Hopefully the next stream is going to be I won't be there to be able to report afterwards or get any clips or pictures, so hopefully the next stream is going to be working. Thank you though, Ian, cheers for that, mate. I hope you've escaped from the bush. Certainly thank you to everybody else that's watching. We've got loads of videos coming up. We're going to have a cup of tea during the week, lots of transfer shows. The transfer shows can't keep coming, surely, because we can't keep signing players. But the manager asked for lots of players, and lots of players is what he's got. Please do, as I said, subscribe. Join us on hammerschat.com. Click the link below for the One Football app. Not much left of the weekend. Have a very, very good week, people, and I will see you, no doubt, online during it. Thanks for watching.
Top Spur?
No.
What's that?
You never heard of them?
No.